Hi friends, welcome back to another powerful video. And my today's topic is attitude. Attitude is everything. Firstly, I would like to thank all of my friends who had shown tremendous response to my previous video. And my previous video was on youth, the burning issue. Really, if my previous video has reached to at least one youth, I am success.
I am very much happy to inform you that many of my friends have suggested and requested me regarding the duration of the video. They suggested me that your videos are long videos, and they requested me to make the short duration videos.
So I request
all of my friends to respect the content of the video and the making of the video rather duration of the video.
In this video, I am going to explain you what is attitude, what is the structure of attitude, what are the components of attitude, and I am going to explain you the importance of attitude taking nature as an example.
Come, let us try to understand attitude first with taking nature as an example.
We must learn from the nature and its component. We must learn from the animals. Animals are the best part of the learning. We can learn much things from the animals. Lion is called as the king of the jungle. Lion is called as the king of the animal kingdom. When we talk about the lion, lion is not the tallest animal. Lion is not the heaviest animal. And lion is not an intelligent animal. Even lion is not the largest animal. But lion is the king of the jungle. Many of the animals, almost all the animals of the animal kingdom regards lion. The tallest animal, giraffe, regards the lion. The smartest animal, fox, regards the lion. Monkey regards the lion. Heaviest animal, elephant, regards the lion. Why? All the animals of the animal kingdom regards the lion. It is only because of attitude. Because of attitude. A lion maintains the attitude of afraid, the attitude of fear. Let me explain you with an example, the type of attitude the lion is maintaining. When the lion and elephant, the heaviest animal, elephant, and the lion, the king of the jungle, face each other, come close to each other, what comes into the mind of each other? What comes into the heaviest animal, elephant's mind? And what comes into the animal kingdom, king of the animal kingdom, lion's mind? The word which comes into the lion's mind is my lunch. And what comes into the elephant mind is eaten. What comes into the elephant mind is eaten. Lunch into the lion's mind and eaten into the elephant's mind. That is the attitude. With that attitude, the elephant is leaving, and with this attitude, the lion is leaving. That is what is called attitude of fear. It is my lunch and I will be eaten. That is the attitude. So attitude is everything. Let me give you the statistical importance of attitude in everybody. When we talk about the organization, when we check into the organization, we see a different levels. Different levels of the employees.
lower level and upper level. The lower level of the employee uses 90% of the skill and only 10% of the attitude. And when we talk about the upper level of the employee, that is the MD of the company, that is, that can be the chairman of the organization or anybody who is at the upper level, he uses 90% of the attitude and 10% of the skills. That is attitude. So attitude is everything. And now let us try to understand attitude in a philosophical manner. Attitude is the positive, negative, or the mixed evaluation of a subject, object, person, place, or thing. It is the intensity by which we express our favorism and unfavorism towards the object, place, person, or thing. Intensity by which we express our favorable and unfavorable condition. Try to understand, by which we express our favorable and unfavorable condition towards the object is attitude.
And now let us try to understand the structure of attitude. Attitude consists of three components. And these three components can be understood by ABC. ABC is a model to understand the structure of attitude. What is A? A is the affective component of attitude, into which the person involves with the feeling or emotion of a object. For example, I am scared of spiders. That is the affective component of the attitude. And when we talk about B, B is the behavioral component of the attitude. What is this behavioral component of the attitude? The component of the attitude in which we act or behave towards the object. We act or behave towards the object. For example, I will avoid spiders and I scream when I see them. So we are acting and behaving towards the object. And the C is the cognitive component of the attitude. What is cognitive component of the attitude? The cognitive component of the attitude is nothing but in which the person believe or have the knowledge of the object. Believe or have the knowledge of the object. For example, I feel spiders are dangerous. In this, the person is having a belief or the knowledge of the spider that they are dangerous. So this is the ABC model. A, affective component of the attitude. B, behavioral component of the attitude. C, cognitive component of the attitude. So attitude is everything. Now let us try to understand the types of attitude. There are four types of attitude. Number one, positive attitude. Two, negative attitude. Three, neutral attitude. The fourth one is shrinking attitude. Positive attitude, negative attitude, and neutral attitude can be understood very, very easily. I just want to brief you about the shrinking attitude. The most dangerous type of attitude is shrinking attitude. It has caliber to destroy the image of positive attitude. And it runs in the mind's negativity. Try to understand, it has the caliber to destroy the image of positive attitude and runs in the mind's negativity. So it is destructive. The most destructive type of attitude is sickened attitude.
Every individual in the world is with more or less attitude. Attitude are important because they guide our thoughts, behavior and feelings. When our thoughts are guided properly, when our behavior is nurtured properly, when our feelings are guided properly, definitely we will be the successful person in the world. That is why I say attitude is everything.